Hello students, today we are going to start with a new chapter, that is living organism and their surroundings. In this chapter, we are going to learn basically about the different types of habitats, their adaptation, people who adapt to these situations, and the characteristics of living beings. Now, what does this habitat mean? You can see four pictures here. The first one is of a mountain, the second extreme opposite, that is the desert, the third one is of a forest, and the fourth one is of a sea. There are different living beings that are staying in this extreme different situations. So the natural living place of an organism is called its habitat. Habitat is nothing but the place where we live in. It can be different for different animals, different human beings. An organism depends on its habitat for food, water, air, shelter, etc. Suppose you live in a home. The first thing that you find in your locality is whether you will be easily getting food, water, fresh air is there or not, and the shelter is perfect or not. Similar goes with all the organisms that are present. Several kinds of organisms are found in a habitat. We find different varieties of organisms in each and every habitat. Habitat is further divided in two categories, that is namely terrestrial habitat and aquatic habitat. Now, what is this terrestrial habitat? If a habitat is land, it is called terrestrial habitat. Now, what does this mean? If we live in any kind of land, it can be anything. For example, it can be a desert, it can be a forest, it can be a grassland, it can be a mountain. Any place other than water, if you stay in that position, then you come under the category of terrestrial habitat. In this picture, you can see an elephant playing in the grass. This is a suitable place for him, for an elephant to live. It's grassland. In the another picture, you can see a snow leopard walking in snow. They live in high mountain regions. They are adapted to that situation. Now, the second one is aquatic habitat. The organisms such as fish, whale, squid that live and breed in water are said to be living in aquatic habitat. Aquatic, the term relates to water. Anything, any animal, any plant that lives in water are using aquatic habitat for the surrounding. Biotic and abiotic components. In any habitat, we come in contact with two types of components, that is biotic and abiotic. Let's learn about them. All living beings such as human, animal, plant and microorganisms are called biotic components. They are also known as living components. All non-living things such as soil, water bodies, atmosphere are called abiotic component. They are also called non-living components. Now, if you live in a home, you are a living being, but you are coming in contact with many things that are non-living. So there is a day-to-day contact between the abiotic and biotic components in a natural habitat. In this picture, you can see there are several examples that are given for biotic and abiotic components. The examples are for biotic, plants, animals, bacteria, etc. Abiotic, non-living things, they are water, soil, air, mineral, etc. Adaptation. Adaptation is nothing but the changes that come in a person once it moves from one place to another. Let me explain this to you with an example. Suppose we live in a hot temperature and you plan to go in a hilly region for your vacations. The first thing that we do over there is go and stay there for a while, for a day, so that your body adapt to that situation and you are very much comfortable to that. The presence of a special feature in or certain habitats which enable a plant or an animal to live in its surrounding is called an adaptation. So in this picture you can see there are two bears that are there. Both are of different color. The color is best suited for their adaptation. The white polar bear, they are very much suited in the mountain areas, whereas the brown bear is very much suited for the forest areas and the moderate temperature.